Well, this is what it's all about. The Jeffersonville Red Devils and the Giants of Ben Davis High School are set to play basketball for the state championship tonight. And as I understand, well, let's take a first quick look at the game recap today. With Carmel, a loser to Ben Davis. They lose by 16 earlier in the year. They had lost by 17. That's a recap of game number one. Giller had a nice ball game for the Greyhound. Game number two, the recap scene there. It was Jeffersonville winning by 13, but the game was really, really close right down until the final 4 or 5 minutes of the ball game. So the final score is not quite as indicative as it might be as to how close that game actually was, though Jeff did get a lead up to 22 points. But that's all history. It's time for the current situation. Let's go across the floor now for the pregame festivities, and here is Scott Gregg.
Ladies and gentlemen, for your pregame entertainment and presentation of colors, we are proud to introduce the Northeastern High School Damsels from Fountain City. They are under the direction of Tracy Ross, Mark Kays, and Heidi Thurston. Principal of Northeastern High School is Michael Brown. The damsels will be performing to a special arrangement of the Star Spangled Banner by Sandy Patty.
Yeah!
the Northeastern High School Damsels. Outstanding presentation of our national anthem and the colors. We'll come back with more in a moment. One of your network sponsors is Indiana Bell. Well, the bad news is the Hoosiers of IU have dropped their NCAA basketball contest to Kansas, 83-77. So we welcome all of our viewers just out joining us. Nice to have you here. We are delighted to be here tonight for this, the championship game. And Tom and I have been doing these for a long time. Hilliard Gates is also with us. He's been doing it for a long time. Tom, this never grows old, does it?
No, and it's exciting every time you see it because... You know how kids are unpredictable? Well, we don't know what's going to happen.
Even the coaches know they're not predictable.
That's right.
You said it never grows old?
Yeah.
Speak for yourself.
No, I didn't say you were growing old.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No, not at all. I noticed that we were one man short in our talent crew tonight. What did you do, run the, who was it? Was it Mike that you ran off down there?
No, the coach from Southern Indiana. We didn't run him off. He was great.
Okay. Well, let's get set now to meet the clubs. Let's go again across the floor to Scott Gray. Scott.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Hoosier Dome in Indianapolis for the championship game of the 83rd annual Indiana High School Athletic Association Boys Basketball State Tournament. Here are the starting lineups for tonight's championship game. First for the visitors, the Jeffersonville Red Devils. At guard, a 6'3" senior, number 20, Sherron Wilkerson. At guard, a 5'10" sophomore, number 24, Brad Bixler. At forward, a 6'2" senior, number 12, B.J. Flynn. At forward, a 6'2" junior, number 44, Brien Hanley. And the center, a 6'3" junior, number 50, Corey Norman. Head coach of the 28-2 Red Devils of Jeffersonville, Mike Broughton. And now the starting lineup for tonight's home team, the Ben Davis Giants. At guard, a 5'7" junior, number 10, Donald Mallory. At guard, a 5'11" senior, number 20, Scott George. At forward, a 6'3" sophomore, number 30, Damon Frierson. At forward, a 6'3" senior, number 50, Micah Reed. And the center, a 6'8" senior, number 52, Damon Parks. Head coach of the 27-2 Giants of Ben Davis, Steve Whitty.
You have met the two clubs. We'll tip it off in just a moment. One of your network sponsors tonight is DuPont Ag Products. We're back live at the Hoosier Dome. Before the ball game, Tom, I was out in the outer area out there, and a young man walked up to me and said, who do you think's going to win tonight? And I said, well, you know, it doesn't make any difference. I'm hoping for a good game. I talked, and I said to him, I said, well, who do you think might win? He said, well, I'm Scott George's brother. I guess I'm going to root for Ben Davis. It was a great, great situation, I guess.
Well, he was looking for a little support.
That's exactly what he was looking for. Ben Davis at 27-2. They beat Carmel 62-46. Jeffersonville at 28-2. They beat South Bend St. Joe 87-74.
Gary Leisner and Ray Tebbe, the officials tonight. Gary Leisner will toss it up here to start this contest.
And stepping in for Jeffersonville is Corey Norman. And Damon Parks will jump for the Ben Davis Giants. We'll toss it up again, I believe. Yeah. The Giant front line is a powerful bunch of guys. Parks, Reed, and Frierson. See their averages, points, and rebounds. Opening tip controlled by Jeffersonville, and off the opening tip, they miss the opening shot. Rebounded in by Ben Davis with Damon Parks. Tom, what might we look for at the outset of this ball game?
Well, we want to see what pace Ben Davis would like to play the game. We know what Jeffersonville's preference is going to be.
Here's the tip, but saved that time by Micah Reed.
Well, they were going to try to post down low to Damon Parks that time, and there's a walk as Reed has trouble getting a hold of the basketball. Looks like they're going to try and take it inside and force Jeff to play defense down low. But the big thing Ben Davis has to do is get back on the defensive end.
Because that's what Jeffersonville did earlier today to South Bend St. Joe. They just flat beat him back time and time again. Here's the steal. It's George and Mallory. Here's the little guy. Great play by Don Mallory. Mallory did not score a lot today, although he did have 14 points, which is well above his 5.2 average. But he was really the catalyst, Tom. He turns things around for Ben Davis. Off the board and good.
Well, Corey Norman, he has had just a wonderful day. He got Jeff off to that good start this afternoon. Winds up with a bank shot from the left baseline.
And we're tied at 2. 1 minute into the championship game here at the Hoosier Dome. Baseline left side, left-handed shot, nothing to the bottom of the net for Damon Frierson.
Yeah, he's shown a lot today. Frierson had a good ball fake that time, got himself free from B.J. Flynn. Both teams playing man-to-man. We're going to see some combinations of defenses, obviously. One thing on Jeff's outlet pass down the floor, Ben Davis has put themselves in a good position. George intercepted one and just deflected this one out of bounds.
Keep in mind also that Ben Davis had a little more rest. Well, here's the shot actually lost in the air by Sherron Wilkerson. And Ben Davis comes off with it. Here's the lead pass up court now. And the one-handed push shot that is good by Damon Parks.
Well, you can tell Steve Whitty wants so badly for Damon Parks to be a part of this game offensively. They're going to go to him, and he came through that time.
Jeffersonville with the basketball. Brad Bixler outside, and now the shot on the way by B.J. Flynn. Taken off. Here's the lead up court. This is Scott George. And Scott George has 2, and just as quickly as we can say that, Jeffersonville will take timeout. With 6:10 to play in the opening period, Ben Davis has jumped to a 6-point lead, 8-2. Back in a moment, one of your network sponsors is IHSAA.
Jim Barber back at the Hoosier Dome. For those of you who pride yourself on perfect attendance, take note of this. 60 years in a row, Dutch Surface has been at the state finals. How can that be? You only look a day over 50.
Well, I have to be 76 years old.
That's amazing.
And it's been a good life. I love it. And I can't hardly pass it up when I get to see a big tournament like this or any other tournament.
Of course, you're the father of Mark Surface, who coaches at Marion High School and took the football team down here to play the Ben Davis Giants in the championship. What do you make of the finals being in a big place like the Dome?
Oh, I think it's too big, but I like basketball, so we're all here, so I guess we can enjoy it.
All right, Dutch, thanks for stopping by, and many more years for you.
Thank you, Bart, Jim. It's been nice being here.
Dutch Surface working on his 60th year in a row, Jerry.
All right, Jim. Brien Hanley scored for Jeffersonville, making an 8-4 ball game. Here come the Red Devils back on the attack. Penetration move inside. Micah Reed is off the mark, got his own rebound, put it back up and missed it again, but we'll go to the free throw line, I assume, off the foul from Ben Davis. And the foul is on number 30. That'll be Damon Frierson. That's the first of the ball game against Damon Frierson. Up-tempo ball game, and I started to make reference to this fact that Ben Davis, Tom, had about a 2-hour jump on Jeffersonville and getting to the hotel and getting some rest because our half times were a little bit elongated today. And so maybe they lost a half hour in preparation time that they might not normally have had.
Well, that's true, and I think one of the things, Ben Davis is going to try and take the ball up the floor, and if they have the advantage, certainly they're going to take it to the basket. If they feel confident, if they don't, they can pull it up and run their offense.
Corey Norman hits them both for Jeff.
Boy, a very average free throw shooter on the season, but he's pumped up today.
He is a 2 out of 2. He shot only 56%. That's the reference Tom was making. It was free throw shooting over the long season.
Dana Overton is in the ballgame now for Jeffersonville. He replaced Brad Bixler. Overton, a senior coming off the bench. Did not score this afternoon. He's not much of a scorer, but he's a good athlete. He's going to guard Mallory right now.
You look down the rosters, Todd. There weren't many scores in either ball club. Ben Davis had only five players score, and you say Jeffersonville with only six players scoring.
Yeah, Connor came off the bench to get 10 for Jeffersonville, and Ben Davis got no points off the bench this afternoon.
3 minutes into this championship game, the pull-up outside jumper is on mark from David Wyerson. It's a 10-6 ball game with Ben Davis on top. It was an 8-2 game at one apair. 4:54 to go here in the opening quarter. Steve Whitty, the head coach of Ben Davis. Mike Broughton, the head coach of Jeffersonville. He brought the Red Devils here last year. And by his admission a few moments ago, that is of some value. Just nothing more, Tommy. He knows how to find a hotel and how to get throughout the arena.
Scott George whistled for the foul that time. Once again, going for the quick pass down the side of the offensive court.
Well, this guy was a major factor this afternoon. Brien Hanley.
Well, he is tough when he gets the ball inside. The big body, you can't, as we said this afternoon, you can't front him, can't get around, and he'll take it to the basket with a spin move if you go one side or the other. You just about have to stay behind him.
He had 25 points and 8 rebounds of that victory over South Bend St. Joseph's. Batted against the board a couple of times, and the rebound comes out long range to Corey Norman. Norman gets it over to Sherron Wilkerson, yet to be heard from in this ball game. Offensively, here's the rebound by Damon Frierson.
Well, he continues to amaze me, the type of tournament that Damon Frierson is having. He got a big rebound there. He's already hit 2 big baskets.
This young man with the basketball, number 10, is a kid named Don Mallory, a 5'7½" junior. And he was one of the reasons that Ben Davis made that strong fourth quarter surge. Here's a three that is up and good by Scott George. Scott comes into this tournament with 83. He had one this afternoon. Now he has one tonight. And it's 13-8 in favor of Ben Davis. Sherron Wilkerson misses badly at the other end. Ben Davis, pull-up jumper short. Picked out of the air, put back up and good by Damon Parks. And it's a 15-8 ball game. The biggest lead so far for Ben Davis at 7.
Good job by Micah Reed. He had a chance on that break to really run into Overton and might have had a charge. Overton had good position. Reed showed what a good athlete he is, had good control of the body, and they wind up with a basket on the opposite side.
3 minutes, 15 seconds to go, and Mallory just flat took it away from Dana Overton. Here's the shot. It will go. It will count, and the foul is called. Boy, Mallory's an amazing young man. Watch him here.
Well, you see him with Overton, strips the ball, has a little trouble getting control. But now he's good in this. One-on-one, even at 5'8". Overton backs off, gets the roll on the board, and he's going to be at the free throw line.
Earlier today, 14 points, 3 assists for this young man, Donald Mallory. He hit 4 out of 5 field goal attempts and was perfect in 6 trips to the free throw line. 5 points for Mallory, and it's a 10-point, 18-8 lead. Well, the Giants of Ben Davis High School, Sherron Wilkerson hitting for the first time.
Well, Wilkerson's going to be able to get a shot about any time that he wants to get one. He's been off target badly a few times early, but put that one home.
Loose ball, deep left corner, chased down there by Damon Frierson.
Bixler back in the game for Jeffersonville. Both teams still playing man-to-man defensively.
Pull up out front is short, but a foul call.
Well, they bring Reed up from the baseline opposite the guard, and it's going to be on Henley that time, I believe.
They showed Bixler.
No, it's going to be Bixler. You're right. Yeah, there's Bixler. Henley had him up front.
For those of you who might not have been with us for the telecast earlier this morning and this afternoon, Jeffersonville, I think, can safely lay claim to the fact they're the all-haircut team.
They really have a lot of style, don't they?
I tell you.
From the bald head. I don't know, what do you call those things that B.J. Flynn has? Brent Connor is on the floor now for the Red Devils as Corey Norman's taking a rest. And maybe one thing Mike Broughton tries to do is kind of rotate some people. Try to keep fresh legs.
Micah Reed, 2 out of 2. Ben Davis is 3 out of 3 as a ball club from the free throw line. It goes to 20-10, back to the 10-point lead, and just as quickly, B.J. Flynn answers at the other end for the Red Devils of Jeffersonville High School.
Well, there's what Ben Davis has to be wary of. They got the 2-on-1 real quickly, and they back Reed underneath, and B.J. was able to hit the jumper.
2 minutes, 22 seconds to play. First quarter, lob inside is a super entry pass right into the arms of Damon Parks. He has 3 field goals and 6 points. And the lead goes back to 10, at 22-12, Ben Davis. Stop and go dribble, Sherron Wilkerson. Deep left corner, B.J. Flint. Now they go inside, and Mallory stripped it away.
Quick hands, Don Mallory once more.
Walking violation on Scott George, and Mallory kind of gave it to him in between hops, and he turns it over. A minute 56 to play in this first quarter. Substitution for Jeff. They'll reinsert Corey Norman, and they'll remove Brent Connor.
Well, last time Jeffersonville put four men down low on the baseline and let Wilkerson have it outside with a lot of room. Now they have four down low with Bixler out. Wilkerson may come out. No, they're going to ping Flynn out to get the ball.
Well, they put Mallory on Brad Bixler, and Bixler is really just having to work hard to get free. We'll have a held ball. The possession arrow will give the possession to Ben Davis. With a minute 42 to play in the first quarter. Last year, Ben Davis, 23-4, losing to Richmond in the championship game of the Indianapolis semi-state. Jeffersonville was 24-3. They made it all the way to the finals, got to the afternoon game and lost in OT to Richmond, 94-92. And George Griffith then took the Richmond Red Devils onto the state championship 1 year ago.
Half-court trapping defense now for Jeffersonville, the first time we've seen that.
Damon Parks with another field goal. He has four field goals, and it's a 24-12 lead, the biggest so far tonight for the Ben Davis Giants.
Ben Davis very much ready for that defense. They did a nice job, got it where they wanted it, and Parks able to hit the basket.
He's 4-for-4 from the field. Here's Corey Norman. Bustled inside, missed the shot, but Damon Parks hit him on the wrist and picks up his first personal foul in the third against the ball club.
Well, Parks had him in pretty good shape as far as his body position. Then he came down with the arm that time. Going to see Corey Norman working against Parks here. See, his body's in good shape. Got him screened off from the basket. Then he slaps down.
We ought to tell the story again, Tom, on Corey Norman's father, who played in the championship ball club 20 years ago.
Well, 20 years ago, New Albany. The Bulldogs, coached by Kirby Overman, defeated South Bend Adams. That was one of the tournament games played down in the Assembly Hall at Indiana University. And Julius Norman, Corey's father, there's Corey shooting the ball up there, had 25 points to lead New Albany to victory over South Bend Adams. And a double-figure scorer for Adams that night was Steve Austin, who coached St. Joe of South Bend this afternoon.
It's amazing how these lives continue to intertwine throughout the years. In the corner, three-pointer is off the mark with the foul on Bixler, and that'll be two on Brad.
Yeah, it's also going to be three free throws coming for Frierson, I think.
Let's look and see. I'm sure, Tom, they signaled it as a three-pointer.
Yeah, he's behind the line. There's no question about that.
Yep.
Bixler's into it.
Oh, wait a minute. They're not taking any shots at all.
Maybe he said he came back down and got him after the shot.
Now there's the three that's up and good by Scott George. His second three-point field goal of the first quarter, giving him 8 points total, and it's 26-13 in favor of Ben Davis. 27-13. They had another one.
Bixler comes back with a three, and he didn't score this afternoon, I don't believe.
He only had 4 three-pointers, Tom, of the entire season.
Right.
And as you say, did not score in the afternoon game. Less than 45 seconds to go. They'll try the long-range shot, and now both ball clubs have kind of gotten in the outside shooting mode right now.
Yeah, that was a big possession for Ben Davis. I know it's early in the ball game. They have an 11-point lead, time running down in the first quarter, and George takes a shot probably a little too quickly, and James Patterson's on the back, and he's whistled for the foul.
That's number one on Patterson. Here's 44, Brien Hanley coming back in for Jeffersonville. 6'2", junior. And with the score, 27-16, Ben Davis, 35.7 seconds remain in the first quarter.
Now they're going to have Hanley out front with the four down low.
Whistle will stop the play.
Patterson again. Hanley's trying to get posted down low, and James Patterson trying to hold him up.
44, fouling 44. That's number two on James Patterson. There he is. James, a sophomore, 6'4".
And Davis has some young people here that
sure
are
do.
Real ball players with Mallory, Frierson. Patterson's done a good job.
Inbounds pass to the open man left side. Shot off the mark that time by Connor. And here comes Don Mallory with 20 seconds to play in the first quarter. Scott George on the left side. Looking inside, but no place to go to try to get the ball to Damon Parks to bring it out and run the perimeter offense again. Now they've got it where they want it, but the shot is off the mark and rebounded down into the hands of Jeffersonville with two, with one. The shot is up, it's good. If it goes, it's just off the mark by B.J. Flynn. And we have reached the end of the first quarter here at the Hoosier Dome with Ben Davis leading Jeffersonville 27-16. One of your network sponsors tonight is your local Indiana dairy farmer. Back in the Hoosier Dome. Happy to have Bill Sturman as one of our guest coaching experts tonight, the head coach at Columbus North. Bill, your thoughts on the first quarter of tonight's ball game?
Jerry, I tell you what, 11-point lead is a big lead for Ben Davis. They're playing well. They're keeping Jeffersonville from getting down the floor. They're getting good shots. Jeff's a little bit, they're not dominating the boards. They're not great outside shooters, so it's going to be a tough game for them. Ben Davis is going to be hard to beat.
Is the pace quicker than you thought it might be, Bill?
Nope. Both teams like to run. And, of course, if Jeff can get the ball into Hanley and Norman, they'll stay in the ball game. If the other guys shoot from outside, it's going to be tough for them.
All right. Thank you very much, Bill Sturman. And as he mentioned, Brien Hanley. Hanley answers with a field goal of his own for a half a dozen points tonight. It's 27-18 with Ben Davis on top. Just getting underway in the second period here at the Dome. Scott George, he left him alone for three, and he got it. Scott George is on fire. That's his third three-pointer of the night.
Yeah, they've moved around. Brien Hanley was on him that time. There comes a two-pointer from B.J. Flynn.
Second bucket by Flynn.
Flynn's after Mallory now. He's got a little size on Mallory. Flynn stands 6'2", Mallory only 5'8".
Well, we'll see how that matches up then. Mallory at one of the guard spots. Damon Frierson is down high with him. They lob it inside. Off balance when he got it was Damon Parks. Here's the follow up by Parks. It will count. And a foul on Jeffersonville.
Well, that was a nice lob pass inside. We're going to get to see it again. Brent Connor's going to be whistled for the foul. You see Parks missed the first opportunity. Got himself a little far under and very fortunate to get back up and get that rebound so he could put it up and in.
Tom, did you see the head fake that George put though? Because he made the fake outside and that drew the defense up. Then he lobs it in. Nobody to help out.
George, really a big asset all season for the Giants. And a couple of games in the tournament here, he's not really acquitted himself like a big scorer. But tonight, he's really taken charge.
Damon Parks of the semi-state scored 30 points. He had 11 points last Saturday afternoon and 19 on Saturday night. Here's the ball knocked away. Belongs to Ben Davis. Parks was a red-hot shooter in that Indianapolis semi-state. Hit 12 out of 16 from the floor, though he struggled from the free throw line at 6 for 14. And they say he's a McDonald's All-American nominee. So he's a fine young player.
Now, there was a free throw miss, and we talked about Scott George. He kept it alive by coming up and knocking it off the board.
Here's George off balance. Here's the rebound. Knocked in the air and a foul, and they are looking this time at Brien Hanley.
It's on Hanley.
And that'll be number one on Brien. Now, you know, I remember the comments made by Steve Whitty. He said, we can't play Jeffersonville if they play volleyball, and meaning just keep it alive. And right now it's Ben Davis that's keeping the ball alive.
Well, I was just starting to say he has done an excellent job, he being Steve Whitty. There's a shot that's missed, but a rebound and a foul is going to be whistled on Parks. But he's really worked hard at getting his front court people to understand you've got to play tough and you've got to get to the board.
There's some leapers out there tonight. Yep. They're really jumping.
But it is interesting that the game plan for one coach now has become part of his offensive game plan. That foul on Damon Parks was number two. 6:47 to play. First half here at the Dome tonight. Ben Davis leading Jeffersonville 32-20 for the state high school basketball championship. Hanley stops and goes. Boy, he is quick. You look at him, Tom, and you think this guy's got a little bit of extra baggage to carry around, but you get a feeling like that's not excess baggage out there. That's that low muscle fat situation.
Yeah, you've got to stop his dribble. You can't let him take it from the outside and get it down low. There's a turnover. Ben Davis has been pretty fortunate in that category tonight. Now they're going to change their defense. We're going to go to a little zone for the first time tonight.
Turnover situation, 5-3, Jeffersonville. Points off of those turnovers. There's the important story. Ben Davis really doing a job off those Jeffersonville turnovers. Norman. Witten got his own rebound, but somebody pushed somebody into the hoop down there. Indications are it'll be against Ben Davis.
Going to be on Frierson.
That'll be two on Damon. Interesting to note, Tom, in the first quarter, Don Mallory had 4 assists. He only had 3 in the entire game this afternoon.
Jeffersonville now in the bonus. We're going to have Sherron Wilkerson go to the free throw line.
Sherron has been very quiet so far. He has 1 field goal. That came in the first quarter of this ball game. Wilkerson's only taken 3 shots. He's 1 for 3. Now the argument is that's the wrong guy going to the free throw line.
And the officials are going to say we have the right person.
Yeah. Don Mallory is the young man that is talking to the officials. Let's see if we can pick it up on replay here.
There's Frierson from behind. He pushes Wilkerson. There's no question about that.
Officials right on top of it. Jerry Wheatley's our director tonight. Joe Pate is our executive producer. John Osler heading our stats. And if it'll make Steve Woody feel any better, they do have the right guy at the free throw line. He doesn't believe it, but they do. 70% shooter with Sherron Wilkerson. That's his 3rd point.
This is a time when we talked about the periods when the fatigue may set in. These first 2 or 3 minutes of the second quarter usually are one of the periods, and then toward the end of the third quarter.
Wilkerson gets 1 out of 2 for his 3rd point. A couple of minutes into the second quarter of this championship game of the state of Indiana. 32-23 is your score. Ben Davis leads Jeffersonville. Mallory got hammered. And he'll go to the line, and there are some words being exchanged now between Don Mallory and B.J. Flynn.
Well, he took the ball right at Flynn and had to see Hanley waiting for him along the baseline. Frierson's going to go out, and we're going to have Peacock in the ball game. Right there is Reese Peacock, 24, you saw.
6'1½ junior making his initial appearance tonight.
Both teams have some underclassmen that have played major roles throughout the season, and in addition to this day of the state tournament.
Well, you mentioned Ben Davis. They start a sophomore in the form of Damon Frierson. Mallory is only a junior. That gives him a half a dozen points, by the way. And Jeffersonville starts Brad Bixler, who's also only a sophomore.
Well, Hanley's a junior. Corey Norman's a junior.
Mallory, 3 out of 3 from the stripe. Give the little guy 7 points so far. 5:55 to go in the half. 34-23, Ben Davis. Game is tied at 2. And Ben Davis has had a lead the rest of the way. In fact, it's gotten as high as 14 points. And Kenneth Jeffersonville was trying to get back into the ball game. They hit it down to 11, which is where it is right now.
Pretty good job defensively that time by Micah Reed. He's a good athlete against Hanley.
Here's Peacock off the mark on the 3. Here's Sherron Wilkerson. He's headed for IU next year. Well, they'd love to see those shots down in Bloomington. Wilkerson with his 2nd bucket. He has 5 points.
Big possession right here for Ben Davis.
34-25. And we have a whistle for a foul away from the ball on Ben Davis.
That'll be on Peacock as he got tangled up over there trying to set a screen.
And that is the 17th foul against Ben Davis, who will make that walk to the other end of the floor. And we'll have free throw shots. 5:10 to play in the half. 34-25, Ben Davis leading the Jeffersonville Red Devils. Jeffersonville's history, they were the state runners up in 1935, losing to Anderson 23-17. In 1974, they were here in Fort Wayne. Northrop got them by 3, 59-56. They've been to the Final 4 now 7 times, and they have yet to win this baby. Of course, Hilliard, you talked to George Griffith, the head coach at Richmond, about that experience. You get here and you get to thinking, my goodness, will I ever win this thing? And he finally got his last year.
Right.
Flynn, 1 out of 2, has 5.
1 out of 2 right there. We have John Chastain bringing it up court now for the Giants.
Lobbed on the backdoor cut and stepping on the baseline. And near super defensive play that time by Corey Norman.
Well, really, well, that was a tough pass. Chastain was trying to weave in there and get it to Reese coming on a backdoor cut, as you said, along the baseline. The ball deflected out of bounds. Ben Davis retains possession. There's a look at the bench. B.J. Flynn getting a little rest right now.
Bixler came in for him. 5 minutes to go in the first half.
There's one thing about a state tournament. You can't be afraid to use your bench because you're going to need some people.
Here's the pull-up shot out front. Reese Peacock with a beautiful release.
Reese Peacock.
He only averages 3.5 points a game, his first two tonight. 36-26, Ben Davis. The three by Wilkerson, high off the back of the rim. Rebound comes down to Ben Davis, taken out of there by Michael Reed, although he was being battled for by his own teammate, John Chastain. Here's the three. A miss by Peacock. Chased down by John Chastain again. And again, Ben Davis getting a lot of offensive boards and second opportunities.
Peacock only averaging three a season. He's just come off the bench. He's taken three shots already. He did hit one.
Here's the shot short. Sneered out of the air by Corey Norman. Norman had 10 boards in that win over South Bend St. Joe. Hanley, no. Rebound taken down by Ben Davis. Full court pressure by Jeff with just under 4 minutes to play in the first half. 36-26, BD. No place to go for Scott George. He'll set it up long range with John Chastain and George out back. They have James Patterson playing on the high post. Now they have Reese Peacock in the lineup. He'll take the shot. He'll miss the shot, and the rebound picked out of there by Brien Hanley.
Gave him plenty of room to shoot that time.
A near traveling violation by Bixler at the other end. Here's the spin move by Brien Hanley. Todd, I can't get over how quick this kid is when he makes the turn to his left.
Yeah, he's some kid.
We made a reference to his size. He's also a member of that Jeffersonville football team.
He's a tight end. I saw him in basketball for the first time last year. There's a block on Bixler in the Seymour Regional. And he was a real factor in Jeffersonville getting through that final game with New Albany. And didn't slow down a bit when he got here to the state tournament a year ago. Bixler's third foul.
But both these coaches have talked about sharing athletes and how, in fact, I know that Steve Whitty's made it a point in trying to work cohesively with Dick Dullahan out of Ben Davis with that superior football program they have out there. And both coaches allowing their athletes to play other sports and encouraging to do so, as a matter of fact.
Well, I think that's the way it should be. And kids play what they want to play and have fun. Jesse Edwards has now come off the bench. Bixler getting his third foul. They have Brent Connor in there now, and Flynn's rest period is over. He's back on the floor.
It's interesting because Jesse Edwards didn't get a whole lot of playing time in the afternoon game.
Well, he came in with, they had to call time to get the bunch in, didn't
right.
they?
Exactly right. Scott George hits the first free throw. Here's a young man of the line. You see his numbers earlier today. He has 3 3-pointers already in tonight's ball game. He misses the second free throw, and the chase is on between Brien Hanley and James Patterson. One by Hanley with 3 minutes to play in the first half. That's a little out of the range.
A little better inside.
Oh, yeah. Coming up at halftime, the final four medals will be presented to the Carmel Greyhounds and the Indians of South Bend St. Joseph. So if you're fans of either of those ball clubs, stick around and check your favorite athletes out tonight. 2:40 to play in this first half. Tipped away, picked up by Mallory. Nowhere to go. He was mismatched defensively. Now the chase is on in front of his Brent Connor. Knocks it away at the other end. Ben Davis comes back. No advantage number-wise. 3-on-3. Now here is George. Short this time. Rebound, Brien Hanley. Oh, Hanley is everywhere in this ball game. Here's the three. It is good by Sherron Wilkerson.
Well, this is the closest Jeffersonville's been in a while. They're within six.
After trailing by 14, with 2:10 to play first half, 37-31. And they've done it, Tom, with good defense.
Well, that's the case. Ben Davis rattled off 27 points in the first quarter. They have but 10 here in this second period, and we're going to have a timeout.
Indeed we are, so we'll do the same with a 37-31 Ben Davis lead. We'll pause for a moment. One of your network sponsors tonight is Farm Bureau Insurance. Jerry Baker along with Hilliard Gates and Tom Henschen back at the Hoosier Dome. And we made reference to a strong first quarter scoring, Tom. We get some information from our stat crew across the way. A couple of records set in the first quarter.
Yeah, that was a record for first quarter scoring in a championship game. 27 points by Ben Davis. Rushville had the previous high going back to 1976 when they played Marion. And a combination of both teams. There's 5 seconds. They can't get the ball in. 43 points. Ben Davis and Jeff scored tonight in that first quarter. It was his 27-16 period. And that replaces the previous high of 41 when Rushville led Marion 25-16 at the end of the quarter. in the 76 championship game. Five turnovers apiece. Wilkerson short, rebound to Scott George. Foul should be on. No, it's not a foul. It's something out of bounds.
He took the rebound and came down right out of bounds.
Well, I think Wilkerson kind of
helped him a little bit.
Yeah, he helped him get outside.
But they didn't call it.
No, it's going to be Jeffersonville ball. Sherron Wilkerson will inbounds. He has Brent Connor on the floor with him. Jesse Edwards is out there likewise. They have big Brien Hanley, who's playing so very well.
Now Brent Connor off the bench. He's a real force coming off there.
Here's Hanley missing, following up and scoring. Hanley with a four-point first quarter has scored eight in the second, 12 of the night. And the lead is down to four, 37-33. Ben Davis. Jeffersonville on a strong run because they were down by 14 points.
One thing about Jeffersonville, their defense can continue to come at you. They'll keep coming and coming and coming.
This is as close as Jefferson has been since it was a 10-6 score. Now Jeff can cut it even closer. Wilkerson in the corner right side. They got it inside instead to Hanley. Hanley with 14. And the 6'2 junior is only four shy of a scoring average. Now we'll see if Ben Davis can withstand the pressure. They got a great move on the baseline. Don Mallory got the ball to Micah Reed. And this 6'3 and a half senior who averages almost 8 a game gets his first two tonight. Sherron Wilkerson answers at the other end.
Jeffersonville showing you at their best when the play gets up and down and up and down. They don't wither under that type of play.
Oh, they love that. I got a feeling.
Flourish.
You got to hurry to get it across the timeline. Ben Davis does. A half a minute left here in the first half. And a turnover deep right corner that time by James Patterson. And now Jeffersonville's got a shot at tying this ball game. Steve Winnie has watched his ball club's lead go from 14 to 2. And Jeffersonville has the basketball.
Well, they're going to go to a four corner here and run the clock down. It's 20. 17 seconds.
They may want it in the hands of Wilkerson or Hanley. Hanley's been so good in the first half. They've got it to him now. He is double, triple teamed. Can't get it rid of it. Finally does to Jesse Edwards. They won't even get a shot away.
They didn't get it away in time.
Great defense employed by Ben Davis. I mean, when they got the ball to Hanley, who was the logical target, Tom, three guys came at him. He had no opportunity to get a shot away at all. Stick around with us here. We're going to take a short break and come back to the presentation of the Final Four medals. There's your halftime score. It's a good one. One of your network sponsors tonight is Indiana Bell. The lead as high as 14. At one time, the score was 27-13. You got to go back to 4:44 to play in the first quarter, and that is as close as Jeffersonville has been since then at a 10-8 score. A number of young men have come to the front, Tom, and said, we see Ben Davis now coming back onto the floor. You got to have a lot of people, and you said it best, you got to play some people off that bench. You can't go with the five on the floor, although, as we pointed out, Ben Davis didn't have anybody coming off the bench to score earlier today, and Jeff only had one, but they still provide some amplification as far as playing time is concerned.
Well, you have to use them. You can't play scared. If you've got them on your roster and they're suited up, you've got to get them on the floor. Now, there are certain times, obviously, that you've got to go with the people that are considered to be your best, but over the entire 32 minutes, you got to use people. In the last 6 minutes of that second quarter, Ben Davis only scored 5 points. Jeff had a 14-5 run, and of course, those 6 minutes is what got them right back here in the ballgame.
You talked about using the people that dancing with the folks who've rung you. Scott George is one of the young men for Ben Davis that had played so well all year long, and when it comes time to tournament time, you got to depend on him again.
Well, there he shoots out of the left corner, a three-pointer, and he had a nice first half. Really got help get Ben Davis off to a good start.
Well, we called Brien Hanley's name I don't know how many times in the first half of this ballgame. I want you to watch the sequence now. Now watch him, number 44 in red. Watch, he'll tip the ball here. Boom, right there, he gets a piece of it. Now watch how quickly he gets up court.
Well, there's Brent Connor to Wilkerson. They're going to find that Hanley got himself down low where they like to get him the basketball. There it is. Micah Reed does his best. If Micah Reed's trying to keep him from penetrating, he's going to have to play a little taller in there because Hanley just goes all over the man in front of him.
Well, Scott George has provided 3 3-point field goals for Ben Davis, only one from Sherron Wilkerson for Jeffersonville. So if the outside game becomes significant, it is Ben Davis who shoots 40% of the year and Jeff who shoots 37% of the year. We'll see if that's any kind of a factor at all. There is Sherron Wilkerson warming up. The Jeffersonville Red Devils have returned to the court. We have 16 more minutes of basketball, and it is still very much anybody's game. Halftime score, Ben Davis, 39, Jeffersonville, 37. We'll be back with the second half tap in a moment. One of your network sponsors is DuPont Ag Products. Buzzer has sounded. Both ball clubs will come back out on the floor here, and the second half is underway. Hilliard, a whole lot better basketball tonight, I think, aesthetically, than what we saw this afternoon.
Absolutely, and I think they all know they're playing for the championship. I have a feeling that maybe Jeffersonville didn't get warmed up very well early in the game. There's a shot right there.
I think Scott George wanted to come out of the box firing in the first 5 seconds of the second half. Scott has his third, fourth three-point field goal, giving him 15 points on the night. At the other end, the Red Devils counter and get two back from Corey Norman.
Well, Ben Davis really got fouled up in a switch that time on their defense, and Norman winds up wide open. Nice move by Jeffersonville, however, to get him free.
30 seconds into the second half. Here is Mallory, number 10. He and Scott George are the guards for Ben Davis. Damon Parks in the middle. The wings filled by Micah Reed and Damon Frierson. Here's the steal by Brien Hanley. Henley, a major force, goes inside and missed the layup. The rebound off into the hands of Damon Parks.
He had to underhand the ball. He couldn't get it into with Palmwell.
I think Jeffersonville's got their defense pretty well the way they want it right now. They've got Flynn on Mallory, and he's a little too big for Mallory to get much going against him. Wilkerson guarding Frierson.
Micah Reed missing. The rebound comes off to Sherron Wilkerson.
That's right.
Tom, your feeling is that Ben Davis needs to get Damon Frierson more into the flow of action?
Yeah, he's hit 2 of 3 tonight, only for 3 shots. That's not enough for Frierson. He's a better offensive player.
Here's George guarding B.J. Flynn and also fouling B.J. Flynn. Scott George with only his second foul. Nobody in serious foul difficulty for Ben Davis. Brad Bixler has 3 for Jeffersonville. There's Steve Whitty. Steve Whitty's a guy who really paid his dues out at Ben Davis High School. He was an assistant under Gail Tolles for 11 years. And now is in his fourth year as head coach with a record of 80 wins and only 19 defeats. That's 81%. 3-on-1. Wilkerson is back. Mallory with a no look. And Wilkerson did a good job of shutting him down and a lane violation. Oh, that's great defense by Sherron Wilkerson.
Well, Ben Davis should have taken a shot. They had ample opportunities to go up with it. But they're a little bit spoofed by this Jeffersonville defense right now.
Yeah, when you go inside looking to get your shot blocked, then you've got a problem. 6.5 minutes to go, third quarter. Cut pass inside. Norman. And Corey with 9. And all 4 of the Jeffersonville points here in the second half of tonight's ball game. It's 42-41. Jeffersonville has taken that 14 lead and diminished all but one of them. Now we'll see how Ben Davis reacts to the pressure of not having a pad. They got a lob pass inside, and they got the bucket from Micah Reed.
Reed can take the ball up strong. That was just an excellent pass by Parks. Parks has done that a couple of times this evening.
Flynn dropped it inside, and a traveling violation called on Brien Hanley. One of the few mistakes this young man has made tonight.
Well, they got the big man behind him that time. Not that that made him travel, but I think that's the way you have to defend Hanley.
Now the pressure by Jeffersonville. This is a ball club that is a good defensive unit. Coming into the ball game tonight, they were allowing 61.4, which was the weakest of the final four, but that is diminished in tournament time. Tournament time, they were averaging only 50, allowing only 54.5 points a game. So they cut it down by 9 points a game. 5.5 minutes to go on the third. Ben Davis lead at 3. Ben Davis in the white, trimmed in purple. Jeff in the red, trimmed in white. Scott George, not this time. Rebound kept alive and finally coming down into the hands of Jeffersonville's Corey Norman. There's that volleyball we talked about. Just keep it alive, or somebody on your side can get it. 3 by Sherron Wilkerson. his second three of the game, his 43rd of the year. He did not have one in the afternoon game, and we are tied at 44, and that is only the second time tonight this game has been tied. It's knocked out of bounds to Ben Davis. There was a tie at 2 and a tie at 44, and no lead changes. So as of this point of time, Jeffersonville has never been in front of this ball game.
Wilkerson got hit right on the face with that ball.
Showing no ill effects, though, Hilliard.
No.
Here's that backdoor lob, and did they get Parks for pushing off? They sure did.
Yeah, they're going to call him for pushing. Corey Norman for putting the pressure on him, and to get free, he felt he had to make that push.
Yeah, that'll be three fouls on Damon Parks. So now, will Steve Whitty stay with him? Well, he's going to, at least for the moment. Oh, great steal by Mallory. Here's the lob pass up court. Damon Frierson got the layup. Frierson with six. First time he's answered the bell since the first quarter.
Well, Mallory created another one with a flick of the ball that time. Now they're going to give Wilkerson a lot of room out front and play everybody down low.
B.J. Flynn for the corner. B.J., 7 points, tie ball game, 46.
Flynn may be the best pure shooter on the Jeffersonville ball club. They all can score, but he's a real shooter and has some range.
Comes in the family. His father, Mike, was a 1971 Mr. Basketball. At the other end, Damon Frierson and Tommy were right on. They got him back into the game. He's taken a couple of shots and hit a couple of shots. Entry pass to Hanley. Corey Norman found his teammate Brien Hanley open, and he has 16 now, and it's 48-all.
Another lapse there by Ben Davis defensively. They had a little void down low, and it cost them. There they've got a man free and didn't see him.
Here's the steal. Mallory trying to get there, cannot, and a turnover. Good defense by Mallory as he kind of upset the rhythm that time of Corey Norman.
Well, that was pretty fortunate for Ben Davis and not so fortunate for Jeffersonville. Looked like Norman was going to go or at least be fouled. And he turned it over. As you said, Mallory, he kind of disrupted the flow of the dribble. And Ben Davis now in this tie ball game needing a basket. Jeff and Ben Davis, turnovers. There's the points off the turnovers. Ben Davis a little advantage there.
Lob inside again. Basket is going to count. They got a foul called against Jeffersonville. The basket is good by Micah Reed.
Well, we said in the opening here tonight that foul is going to be on Wilkerson, that we had to have a good ball game for Ben Davis, Micah Reed, for them to have a shot at it. And there he is going up strong.
Micah Reed, 2 out of 2 from the free throw stripe so far in this ball game. Football, all-state football player in college. He's heading for Indiana State, by the way, over in Terre Haute on a football scholarship. The Sycamores will like what they're going to see out of this young man. Here's the defensive play at the other end by Damon Parks. Out of bounds to Ben Davis.
Well, B.J. Flynn was really battling for that one. Here's Parks down the lane, shot by Norman. Flynn's underneath. You see Flynn coming right after him with a basketball, knocked it out of Park's hand, and Ben Davis thus has possession.
Giants lead it 51-48, less than 3 minutes to go in the third quarter. And right off the fingertips of Damon Frierson, and Steve Woody can just sort of throw his head in disgust that time as they turn the ball over one more time. 2:54 to play in the third quarter, and a timeout.
An official timeout.
With the Ben Davis Giants out in front, 51-48. We'll take a break of our own here. One of your network sponsors tonight is Farm Bureau Insurance. Ben Davis led by 2 at halftime. They're up by 3 right now, but we have had 3 ties in the third quarter at 44, 46, and 48. Still no lead changes, though, so Jeffersonville has never been in front of this ballgame.
No, the Giants have been able to hold them off thus far, but the Red Devils certainly don't wither in their attack. And they come after you defensively from head to toe. Their offense sometimes a little sporadic, but They get the ball in the right hands. They're pretty good. Look at there. Not too bad of shooting for
amazing.
Final game of a state tournament.
There's
rebounds. Ben
right
Davis,
there.
Yes, seven up. That's a little surprising.
And a lot of those, Tom, are offensive boards. And Ben Davis has simply been doing the job of just keeping the ball alive. Knock three, picked up by Ben Davis, then thrown away. Now a mad scramble right in front of the Jeffersonville bench, and finally Don Mallory comes out of there with it.
Well, B.J. Flynn passed up a good shot there. He's a shooter, and he should have taken that shot. Patterson in all kinds of trouble.
And finally off to Sherron Wilkerson. 51-48, Ben Davis, 2:15 to play in the third. Wilkerson found the open man, long range, right side, B.J. Flynn off the mark. Rebounded by Norman, up and good. Basket counts, foul is called. And the foul will be on Damon Frierson.
Here's the shot out of the corner by Flynn off the rim. Norman gets the carom, goes up, and contact made by Frierson. Frierson beginning to look like he may be a little weary.
Which might be the reason, Tom, he's not getting the ball and getting a lot of shots.
Yeah,
he played 10 minutes in the first half.
Keep moving.
Yep. Corey Norman has been the leading rebounder in this ball club for two consecutive years. He misses the free throw, but the rebound comes off to Jeffersonville, and they'll start it up all over again. Here's the shot inside and good. Brent Connor. First bucket and the first lead of the game for Jeffersonville. They have come from 14 points behind to take the lead. At the other end, we'll reverse it one more time as James Patterson scores.
Good job by Scott George looking down court, getting it to Patterson.
And a whistle. And a foul. And Damon Frierson again.
Derek Whitty getting set to come in. He may replace Frierson.
That is four on Damon.
Brent Connor, really a quality player off the bench for Jeffersonville.
Take foul number four.
There's Frierson. Here's Wilkerson getting the ball low to B.J. Flynn. He can't get it to fall in, but Brent Connor follows and does get it. Then in the next exchange out here where Jeff picked up the loose ball, Connor had it and was fouled, and he's going to be at the free throw line.
Right now, the official stat board shows that only the third foul on Frierson, so we'll correct it and go with that.
He's staying in the game.
Oh, he banked it. Brent Connor did, but it still counts.
That's just what B.J. Flynn told him. It counts.
Here comes Hanley in, and out goes Corey Norman. Corey leaves the lineup with a great third quarter. He had 6 points, 11 so far in the ball game tonight. Rebound is long to Mallory. At the other end, a nice head fake by Frierson.
Good move by Ben Davis, having the free man at the offensive end. Long rebound, you're automatically up 2-on-1. And Frierson made it count.
A minute 20 to go in the third quarter. Another rebound that comes off long. Nothing but white shirts up court. They didn't get the ball there. Here's the three. Short this time by Derek Whitty. I'm not too sure Dad wanted that shot taken. Loose ball chased down out of the midcourt stripe by Brent Connor right in front of us here.
Brent about to lose a shoe.
Now here's Henley pulling up from 10 and scoring. That's 18 for Henley, and we're locked up at 55.
I think for Jeffersonville fans and Coach Broughton, when that ball's in Henley's hands, you feel pretty good.
Lower right-hand corner of your screen, that's the amount of time left in the third quarter. Good rebound off the offensive board, and Mallory follows with a gimme and misses it. Now Jeffersonville's got a chance to take a lead into the fourth quarter after trailing by two at halftime and trailing by 14 in the first half. Great comeback by the Red Devils.
Time running down, 10 seconds, and the clock running.
Hanley made the shot, but they're not going to count it, I don't think.
I don't think. I think he waved the shot off.
The foul.
Oh, I'm sure he might have counted. Let's see. I don't believe it is.
Team foul number five.
The foul was on Whitty. That's the first on Derek in this ballgame. No, they did not count it. We're still locked at 55.
Corey Norman coming in. He's going to replace Connor. Connor needed time to tie that shoe. He finally got it taken care of, I think, and then he's going to be replaced. Brad Bixler in.
And Jeffersonville get the lead. Sean or Sherron Wilkerson. No, here's the baseball shot that's off the mark, and we're going to go to the fourth quarter. Right back where we started. Tied at 55. Back in a moment, one of your network sponsors, the NFL. Jerry Baker back at the Hoosier Dome, 55 ball. George Griffith, the head coach at Richmond, state champions from a year ago. George, we're going to the fourth quarter all locked up, man. You were here 1 year ago. We got a lot left on the line here for both these ball clubs.
Jerry, can't get any closer than this, can it? I think the king might be about a real major factor here, and I think they got to go to Hanley, and they got to get Parks or Reed, somebody inside for both teams.
Are the butterflies flying around out there a little bit right now, or have they gotten over that already?
No, I think it's over. Fatigue is the thing now.
Well, the bucket by B.J. Flynn is his ninth point of the ball game, and it's now 57 to 55. Another lead change, the fourth of the game, and believe it or not, that is the biggest lead that Jeffersonville has had. 2 points.
Well, Ben Davis lapses down low once again. They can't get weak side help.
Damon Frierson with 12. And he ties the ball game at 57, the seventh time it has been tied. And Frierson, indeed, Tom, has gotten back in the flow of this game. B.J. underneath. Flynn with 11.
Well, they're not sure, I guess, who's going to guard Flynn. I think Scott George is supposed to pick him up, but twice in a row right now, Flynn's been wide open.
1 minute into the fourth period. 59, 57, Jeffersonville. And a timeout by Ben Davis. They almost had to do it. They were going to turn the ball over on the five-second closely guarded call. Timeout BD, one of your network sponsors tonight, is your local Indiana dairy farmer. Indianapolis News
for all the marbles.
We are underway with 6:56 to play. Mike Broughton leading cheers in front of the Jeffersonville cheering section across the way. Only brought a great contingent up from the southern portion of our state.
Here's a good indication to show you how Jeffersonville can really put the pressure on with their defense.
And they force Damon Frierson to take the long range, or make it, pardon, Scott George to take the long range shot. 90 seconds into the final period. And Sherron Wilkerson hit apparently a wet spot on the floor. His foot went out from under him. He is okay, I think. And he is called for a traveling violation. He's being looked at by Scott George. He may have ever do that kind of step off a step, Hilliard, and hit it just wrong, and it just shakes your whole body.
Yeah, but I wasn't that good at basketball.
Well, anybody can do this. And now watch his foot, left foot. Boom. That just really shakes you up. From our low angle floor level camera, left foot is the one to watch. Boom, boom, whoa.
Yeah, it looks like he was trying to get his body to go back and the foot went out in front of him.
Well, it's
hope he's
all
right. A cramp or what the situation might be.
Jeffersonville with Mark Lambertus, the varsity assistant. Al Rabe coaches the JV. They got three guys with a frosh. Mark Miles, John Payton, Junior Harvey. So they'll be out administering to Sherron Wilkerson. Ben Davis, Steve Woody being assisted by Terry Strom, Doug Opel, and Dave Potts. Now they're going to get Wilkerson up and help him on. You got a feeling, Tom, it's one of those injuries that sort of kicks your back a little bit and sort of shocks you for a while.
I think he pulled a muscle in his right leg there.
Well, let's hope he's all right.
At any rate, Dana Overton is going to be his replacement, I think, for the next few moments at least. Jeff on top by two, 6:26 to go. And their defense has certainly taken Ben Davis out of the flow of their offense. They've still been able to post up low, mostly with Micah Reed. That's been about as effective as they've been.
Well, here comes that full court pressure by Jeffersonville. They handle it inbounds to Damon Frierson. 59-57, Jeffersonville, a two-point lead after being down by 14. They've done a remarkable job getting back into this ball game. Scott George looked inside for a moment and thought about it, then changed his mind. He had Brad Bixler right on top of him. Scott George bobbled it. The two red shirts come at him in a hurry. Now he gets it out to Don Mallory.
Got to get a shooter, either Frierson or George coming out top. Reed does not have the range to shoot out there.
And a whistle inside as they drop the ball down low to the postman. And the foul is, I think, on Corey Norman.
That's only the second team foul, I think, on Jeffersonville. They've played a little over a quarter here,
right,
2.5 minutes into the final period without committing but one foul, and now they get their second.
And Ben Davis has committed five, in case you're wondering. 59-57, Jeffersonville. Ben Davis basketball, 5 minutes and 40 seconds to play. State championship on the line. Here's the near steal at midcourt by B.J. Flynn, and kicked out of bounds by Don Mallory. Mallory had already set his sights on heading back up court. It actually turned his head.
Well, we're going to see this again. Flynn anticipates very well. He's a little tripped up right there, and then they fall over each other, and Mallory, that may be a little sign of fatigue right there.
So Jeffersonville has a chance to kick the lead to its largest margin as far as they are concerned tonight. They're up by two. They drop it inside to Hanley. Brien Hanley with 20. And that is their biggest lead at four. Hanley with another great ball game. He had 23 points and 10 rebounds. He'll make it 25 points and 8 rebounds in the afternoon victory over South Bend St. Joseph's. Tonight, he's in the 20-point category again. Here's a three. It's short. Rebound picked up and put up there by Michael Reed. He is in double figures with 11. He's the fourth Ben Davis Giants to hit double figures. We're inside 5 minutes to play, though, with Jeffersonville on top, 61-59. Hanley out high. The defense employed by Damon Parks. He is right inside of his jersey. So Hanley backs it out. Now starts to move it inside. Drops it off down to the baseline. Loose ball on the floor. Jeffersonville comes out of there with it. Here is Hanley again. Now long range to B.J. Flynn. 4.5 minutes to go.
I got a mismatch underneath Flynn. Mallory trying to guard him at 5'8". Ball deflected out of bounds. Now Mallory's indicating to George, you get out here and take this guy.
Wise decision. Jeffersonville's 14th trip to the Sweet 16. They're seventh in the Final Eight, seventh time in the Final Four. They have not won it in the history of the school. In the corner, off the mark. And a whistle.
It'll be on Corey Norman. He's on the back of Scott George.
Put his left hand right on his back and ball to try to ball up there with a ball.
That's two on Corey Norman. We'll take a look at it.
Well, Jeff had their good shooter, B.J. Flynn, taking the shot. George trying to screen Norman away, and he does effectively enough to get the call.
They're still working on Wilkerson on the bench.
And Davis needs to get some good spacing here so they can't get double teamed by the Jeff defenders.
Here's the pull up three, and it's off the mark by Scott George. Scott has 4 3-pointers, one here in the second half. In fact, that 3-pointer that he has in the third quarter accounts for all of his points in the second half. 61-59 Jeffersonville, 3:45 to play in the game.
Well, Jeff needs to really work hard here, and a basket would be a big help to them.
Dana Overton in this ball game at a crucial time. Sherron Wilkerson still on the bench, as Hilliard pointed out. Here is Hanley. Hanley turns. Hanley couldn't get it. Rebound into the hands for a moment of Frierson. He comes out of there. Now we got a 2-on-1 the other way on B.J. Flynn. They got the layup. They got the tie ball game. Damon Parks scoring for the first time in the second half. Makes it 61-all. And timeout by Jeffersonville. So we do the same. We'll take a break on the IHSAA television network. One of your network sponsors is Farm Bureau Insurance. 13 to play, tied at 61. Action Tom Hessian from coast to coast.
Well, here's the play that tied it. George gets it up down the court. There's a nice pass going underneath. Reed to Parks, and Damon Parks laid it in and tied it at 61.
We are tied for the eighth time tonight with 3:05 now to play. Jeffersonville in red, Ben Davis in white. Giants, Ben Davis, first trip ever to the Final Four. Jeffersonville, over the last 3 years, they've had a great success story down south. as Mike Broughton has sent eight of his players to play in college, major college basketball. Now, Sherron Wilkerson coming in. They had him doing jumping jacks on the sideline a while ago, or at least he was jumping, trying to stretch out those muscles in the legs. I think it may be cramping as much as anything else that's bothered him, although he did jolt himself when he went down a few moments ago.
Every possession now a big one for both teams.
Here's Wilkerson. A little far out for the three-point shot. They clear it left side now. Great defensive play by Damon Parks. Stolen away at the other end by Pritchler. Three on nobody and a foul call. They are pointing, I think, toward Mallory. We'll wait and see.
And I think you're going to be right.
First foul on Don Mallory. Well, the pressure is really on this defense of Jeffersonville right now. Here's the defensive play. Now watch what happens at the other end here. Jeffersonville has stepped up their defensive efforts.
Well, they had the numbers. They didn't get the ball in the center quickly enough. Mallory should have gotten it to the middle of the floor quickly. Then they had some options.
Back to live action with 2:19 to play. We are tied at 61. A much better championship game than what we saw in the morning and the afternoon game here. Well, these Cubs have got to be just a little bit fatigued.
Well, one of the real steady performances of the night, Micah Reed. I don't think he's been out all night. He made a defensive play there, knocked the ball out of bounds.
Well, here's good job. Jeffersonville bench. Their average tournament win over seven games was 24-plus points.
Well, the clock right now is down to 2 minutes and a 61-61 ball game.
Well, there is no shot clock in high school basketball, so they can play keep away as long as they desire. A minute 50 to play. Boy, here's a guy you want to have the basketball if you're a Jeffersonville fan. That's 20 points and a turnover. And Scott George running the right side. Now Scott has got it. But very quickly, the defense of Brad Bixler gets out to grab him. A minute 35 to go on this game. Micah Reed, Tom just talked about him. The entry pass is stolen away, but there was a foul called on Corey Norman from behind.
Well, Reed, once again, very intent on what he had to do. He wanted to get the ball down low to Parks. Parks really didn't come to meet it very well, but he was fouled from behind.
And Tom, that's only the third team fouled against Jeffersonville, so they're in pretty good shape right now. They can play aggressive defense if they so desire. Scott George in the corner, missed it. Tipped in the air once, twice, picked off the board. Rebound shot is off the mark that time by Parks, and here comes Jeffersonville again. There are bodies flying everywhere. Climbing off the deck is Damon Frierson and Brien Hanley. No foul call, no harm out there. Completely away from the action, but it just shows you how intense things are. A minute five to go on this ball game. And who would have thought after a 27-point first quarter that Ben Davis would only have 61 with a minute to go in the contest? They set new records for a single team, and two team totals in the first quarter was 27-16.
Well,
Norman.
Jeffersonville a lot going for him here in addition to just a possession. Should they give it up, they can give a foul too.
And here is the foul on Parks.
It's going to be Norman at the free throw line. Now he's a very average shooter on the season, but he's come through here today with some pretty decent free throw shooting.
He's 3 out of 5 tonight, Tom.
Right.
It was almost as though they were waiting for the ball to get in his hands, and then they went over and made the foul. This has been a super basketball game. Corey Norman at the free throw line. Only 11 points in the entire semi-state last week. And he had a 23-point, 10-rebound afternoon and a timeout by Ben Davis. They'll let Mr. Norman think about this for a second. 39 seconds to play. We're tied with Jeffersonville and Ben Davis at 61. And Jeff's going to the free throw line. One of your network sponsors, Indiana Bell. We're back. You know, Tom, Mike Broughton may want to buy one of those sweatshirts that lady has on. It says, "We're back." And what that says is not just back to the Final Four, but they were all but having final rights granted to them when they were down by 14 points. But they're back now.
Yeah, that was a little early to pronounce the final rights.
Well, let's see if Mr. Norman can get the job done here. Norman, 6'3 junior. Yes! 12 points for Corey. What a day he's had, a 35-point day.
And a birthday.
Norman has rebounds, half a dozen. He missed the second one, but the rebound taken down by Jeffersonville and put up and good by Brien Hanley. Hanley with 22. 64-61. Both ball clubs have timeouts left. Each have two.
Jeff can give some fouls right here, too.
Don Mallory. They've almost got to go for the three. Here is the three by George. Off the mark. Rebounded by Jeffersonville. Tipped up court. Here's B.J. Flynn.
Well, that's it. Time's not out.
They throw the ball the length of the court with 5 seconds to go. And Jeffersonville has already begun to celebrate.
Mike Broughton wants a timeout.
He will get the timeout, so we will take one also. Stay with us, 5 seconds to play. One of your network sponsors is IHSAA. Jeffersonville is a school rich in tradition, a number of big plays over the years, but maybe none any bigger than Brien Hanley's bucket just seconds ago. Here's the missed free throw by Norman.
There it is.
And Jeffersonville is going to win the state championship. They got it up court. Here's the hook shot that's out of bounds. It doesn't matter. Jeffersonville has finally broken the chance. Their third trip to the state championship. 1935, they lost to Anderson 23-17. 1974, Fort Wayne Northrop got them 59-56. And Mike Broughton has been astounding in his 3 years as the head coach of Jeffersonville. 21-4, 24-3, 29-2, and state champions. Enjoy this. Championship shirts out, and the players are putting them on. Now that is confidence. And I see that Mike Broughton is being brought in our general vicinity. He is with Hilliard Gates. Let's go to Hilliard and the winning state championship coach. Hilliard.
Mike Broughton, I can tell by just looking at you what this moment means to you.
That's been a real blessing, I tell you. I can't explain in words what it means. They've worked so hard, and the good Lord's just been good to my family and to the whole group of them. And we've just hung in there, and I'm just, I can't even explain it, to be honest.
I'm sure you can't explain it, but it'll all come out tomorrow and the rest of the week and the rest of your life. Jeffersonville has never won this championship before.
After 7 tries, and I got to thank George Marshall and all the other people that gave it a whirl, but you know what? They can't say we haven't won it now. Yeah. And I just want to thank the people and the players, and above all, I want to thank my wife. She was didn't get to go last week. She was in surgery, and I love her greatly. I'm glad she was able to make it. They carried her down here today.
You took turns at having heroes here tonight.
We just won on heart. It was just on heart. I'll tell you what, we really just stayed with it. We got behind 14. They jumped us. They just played awful well the first half.
You learn your lessons well, because frequently a team comes down here and gets defeated the year before and then come back and wins it.
Well, I'll tell you what, ever since we went into that locker room at Richmond, it was an empty feeling, and we just made an effort to make it back, and you know what? We won 9 in a row.
Well, congratulations. You're a wonderful young man.
Thank you. I may never make it down here again, but I want to thank you, because I've watched you all those years, and I always wondered what it'd be like. It's better than I thought.
Thank you very much. Congratulations. All right. All right, Jerry.
All right. Mike Broughton's record now with Jeffersonville over 3 years, 74 wins, 9 defeats. That is amazing. We'll come back with the post-game festivities in a moment. One of your network sponsors tonight is DuPont Ag Products. Not take the lead until it was 52-51. That's how long it took them to finally get it. When they got it, there were 4 lead changes, and they win it by a score of 66-61. I think we're ready now for the post-game festivities. Here is again Scott Gregg.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, the Indiana High School Athletic Association would like to make the presentation of the runner-up medals to the Ben Davis Giants. Making the presentation are two members of the IHSAA Executive Committee, Larry Gambiani of the Washington Township Schools and Larry Pinkerton of Plymouth High School. Presenting first to Ahmed Bellamy. Jonathan Chastain. Damon Frierson. Scott George. Vincent Durnell. Donald Mallory. Mark McLaurin. Damon Parks. James Patterson. Reese Peacock. Micah Reed.
I'm gonna run out of room here, Jerry.
Darren Whitty. Eric Tibb, student manager. Assistant coach, Terry Strong. Head coach, Steve Whitty. Athletic director, Bob Britt. Principal, Dr. James Mifflin. Student manager, Shane Rosenbaum. Assistant coach, Doug Opel. Assistant coach, Dave Patz. Mark Lahr. Assistant athletic director, Priscilla Dillo. And now, ladies and gentlemen, to make the presentation of the runner-up trophy to your 1993 IHSAA State Basketball runner-up Ben Davis Giants, Mr. Larry Gambiani and Mr. Larry Pinkerton. Ladies and gentlemen, your 1993 IHSAA runner-up Ben Davis Giants. It's time to make the presentation of the championship medals to your 1993 state champion Jeffersonville Red Devils. Making the presentation, two members of the IHSAA Executive Committee, Mr. Steve Reardon of Lawrenceburg High School and Mr. Don Sockel of Floyd Central. Presenting first to Brad Bixler. Doug Boyce. Brent Connor. Jesse Edwards. BJ Flynn. Brien Hanley. Courtney Martin.
Congratulations.
Corey Norman.
Good job, Corey. Now you and Dad both got one, don't you?
Dana Overton. Giannis Sanders. Sherron Wilkerson.
Congratulations, Sherron. Good luck.
out to you.
Nelson Yates. Assistant coach Mark Lambertus. Assistant coach Al Raley. Head coach Mike Broughton. Athletic director Ralph Scales. Principal Ward Weber.
Congratulations, Ward. Let me put this on you first.
Assistant coach John Pate.
Congratulations.
Assistant coach Clark Miles. Assistant coach Junior Harvey. And trainer Jane Kendall. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the presentation of the championship trophy to your 1993 state champion, Jeffersonville.
A moment they will never forget. The state champion Jeffersonville Red Devils. We'll come back with the Trestor Award winner in just a moment. One of your network sponsors is Farm Bureau Insurance. Has the announcement.
Our final presentation of the evening, the presentation of the Mental Attitude Award. It's my honor to introduce a member of the IHSAA Executive Committee, Mr. Herb Ressler of Goshen High School, to make the presentation.
Ladies and gentlemen, can I have your attention, please? A Mental Attitude Award is presented in each of the 18 IHSAA sports. In addition to the award, Farm Bureau Insurance, the proud corporate sponsor of all IHSAA tournament events, will award a $1,000 scholarship to the school's general scholarship fund in the name of the recipient of the Mental Attitude Award. Before I name the winner of the Arthur L. Tressler Mental Attitude Award, I would like to invite the parents of the recipient to please come to the award stand to share in this honor. This Mental Attitude Award, the recipient of this award while a student in grade 12, was nominated by the principal and coach, excelled in mental attitude, athletic ability, scholarship, and leadership during the 4 years of high school. Participated as a state finalist in the sport of basketball and was selected by members of the IHSAA Executive Committee. Ladies and gentlemen, the 1993 winner, number 31 from South Bend St. Joe High School, Pete Miller.
Here is Pete Miller, a four-year starter for South Bend St. Joseph, selected as the Trestor Award winner. He is the son of Brian Lewis Miller up in South Bend. Hilliard will talk with him in just a moment. Pete played 27 minutes in the afternoon game. Hit 3 out of 13 from the field, 1 of 8 three-pointers, 2 out of 2 from the line, 3 rebounds, 2 assists, 2 steals, total 9 points in that afternoon loss to Jeffersonville, the eventual state champions. Peter Miller. And he is now receiving accolades from members of the High School Athletic Association. Now here comes mom and dad, a proud moment in their lives. Hilliard Gates has joined them on the platform. Let's go out to Hilliard, and at the first opportunity, Hilliard, get a chance to talk with this fine young man, Pete Miller.
And we're on the podium here with a very happy young man who has a marvelous future as a basketball player, and I hear all the wonderful academic things about you. You're going to be wonderful, a great citizen. Congratulations.
Thank you. It really feels good, but just being part of the team like that was the best part of the season, and I really thank my teammates for just being there for me the whole year.
What do you want to do when you grow up and get taller?
I'm not sure. I don't know yet. I just want to go to college and just be happy. I don't know.
Do you have any particular college?
I'm not sure yet. I'm just going to start thinking about it the next few weeks, I think.
What's your favorite subject?
I like
basketball.
Yeah, I like Spanish, like foreign language.
Well, you're a wonderful player and a fine young man, and best wishes to you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Let's talk. Okay, we'll switch it back to Jerry.
All right, Hilliard, we're running a little short of time, but we wanted to make darn sure we got the Trestor Award winner in tonight, Peter Miller. Here's a look at the statistical story of this ball game tonight. It's amazing, Tom, how the field goal numbers were almost identical the entire game.
Great shooting by both teams for a championship game. Jeff really came on.
Well, it's a championship for Jeffersonville, and we're going to show you some folks who were so much involved with our telecast, but you see them realize them, that they were here, especially this crew, all day long. Our director, Jerry Wheatley, did a marvelous job, and you'll see the other members there. Tom, special moments, these are things you go to your grave with, and this is something that I'm sure every coach in his dreams thinks he hopes he'll get, but never really believes it. You can feel that from Mike Broughton.
Well, yeah, it's a special thing for Mike. It's a special thing for all those people from Jeffersonville, Indiana, that have had great ball clubs for a lot of years, thinking it was their turn to win a state championship. We saw it happen to Richmond's Red Devils last year and another set of Red Devils this year.
Well, just to show you the leading numbers in this ball game, we showed you the team numbers. The leading scorer for Jeffersonville was Brien Hanley with 22, also 7 rebounds. And the top scorer for Ben Davis with 15 points was Scott George. It's been a marvelous day with Tom Hessian and Hildyard Gates. I am Jerry Baker. We congratulate again the Red Devils of Jeffersonville High School, coming from 14 points down to make the move to cut down the nets as they win it 66-61. Great crowds, 60,000 or so saw these games at the Hoosier Dome. And next year, who knows, maybe your club will be here. Again, we congratulate the Red Devils of Jeffersonville High School, and so long from the Dome.
You've been watching another Indiana High School Athletic Association championship event. Your network sponsors were Indiana Bell and Ameritech Company, your local Indiana dairy farmer, Winners Drink Milk, ICI Seeds, it's showtime at ICI Seeds, DuPont Classic, Pinnacle, and Assure 2, what makes them better is you, and Farm Bureau Insurance, proud corporate sponsor of all the IHSAA championship events. This is the Indiana High School Athletic Association Television Network.